Everybody say willing.
Willing.
To learn additional skills to build our families and communities. So, let's take a listen to this. Limited perspectives can erode, meaning break down, corrode, make it, you know, not useful to one's ability to make thoughtful decisions. And sometimes people can adopt harmful attitudes. Now, we learn later on that the Israelites developed some things that were not too good. They took their focus off of God many times and end up doing what? Something really key that they always got in trouble for.
Worshiping idols.
All right, there we have it. Worshiping idols. So some of the examples that were other than worshiping idols in the book I have here says, for example, adopting a scarcity mentality, trying to keep everything. Accepting exploitation as normal, desiring to control others. These actions become psychological slavery, requiring no slave master. So sometimes we can enslave ourselves. You know, anybody need some chains broken? You know that song, Break Every Chain? She's not just talking about one simple chain. There's so many things that can enslave us ourselves. And what is the remedy for that? When you're spiritually bound up, you can slave yourself. Amen. There's a renewed trust that needs to take place in God, and He can expand your ability to embrace new opportunities. When you feel that gentle nudge of the Holy Spirit, don't fight it. Go with it. Learn to worship. Learn to be free in your worship. Not just at home, but where? In the sanctuary. Someone else would be touched by your worship to help build the community of worship. Can you imagine what that could be like? We've had a couple of good worship sessions here, for a long time, but there are some that have been just totally awesome. Just, ooh, can't keep still. Anyway, okay. So let's bring it more up to date these days. I believe you all have something called the Black History Spotlight. Do you? Okay, and if we could have a couple of good readers read through that. A couple of good readers. Start reading the Black History Spotlight from about Greenwood in Tulsa, Oklahoma. Who would like to start, please? Ms. Katrina?
The early African American settlers in Tulsa, Mississippi. These men and women sought opportunities and land to establish a settlement away from the virulent racism of the South. It was not unusual for the early black residents to have moved several times before coming. That residents were willing to travel long distances to pursue their dreams. O.W. Gurley was probably the first black to arrive in Tulsa. Born in 1866, Gurley, a son of slaves, grew up in Alabama and later moved to Arkansas. Gurley became a teacher but wanted more for himself and was drawn by the opportunity to acquire land in Oklahoma. He moved to Oklahoma and was part of the land rush in 1893. By 1900, Gurley lived in Cary, Oklahoma, and operated a merchant store.
Next, I'm going to pick up where she left off.
The discovery of the oil in Tulsa provided him with another opportunity for success, given an opportunity to purchase land on the city's north side. He recognized that the land he had purchased could be zoned and sold to black people. Since the Oklahoma Constitution bared all types of racial integration, from housing to telephone, Gurley designated is creating green.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, yeah, you can go on.
Really took many steps to establish Tulsa as a place of opportunity for African Americans. The keen businessman, he understood that segregation meant that black people needed a place to live where they could travel to the downtown core to work. He also understood that businesses needed to come to Greenwood if they were to become a sustainable community. But Greenwood is much more than a place individuals went to make their fortune. What made Greenwood special was the fact that black people worked together to pool their resources to build a community.
Mm-hmm. Wow, that sounds really interesting, doesn't it? Just think about our own city. Are we pooling together in our neighborhood?
No.
Some are. But we need to, every little chance we get, we try to do something. Okay, the last paragraph. There are a couple of gentlemen in the Bible that pooled together, and these gentlemen decided they weren't going to be a part of something, even though they were taken captive. And how shall I say, they were told they had to do something. That they just said, hey, we're not doing it. Okay, and I admire these gentlemen because regardless of what was done to them, they stood together and stayed strong. So here is another, and we're not gonna, unless you want to, we're running out of time. let me see, 1, 2, 3, 4. We're going to remember, who remembers Jake, Drake, and Blake from the other day? You all remember those three little gentlemen? Yeah. And they were asking questions like, what, so what, and now what? So these three gentlemen I'm going to share with you. They're asking the same thing. What is it that you can do building up your community? What things can you learn? I mean, what have you learned? Thus far, this has been, you know, pretty cut and dry, pretty fast here. And then once you reflect on the lesson for today, what are you going to do with that information? These three gentlemen decided they weren't giving in to, was it Nebuchadnezzar that threw them into the fire, right? And they decided, no, we're not worshiping your God. We're just not. And because of their dedication to holding firm, standing on the word of God as they were even in the fire, who join them? Amen. So, if Jesus, well, since Jesus joined them in the fire, as they stood together, building their community of faith among themselves, what were they showing them, the people around them, in that community? We're not giving in. We're going to stand strong. Amen? So, this was just a little something for you to just reflect on about the power of sticking together and building up our community, the community of faith. And one of the greatest ways to do that here at New St. Mark is on Tuesday at 6 o'clock for prayer. Wow, you all said that. So can I expect maybe to see y'all next Tuesday? It's going to be in September. Think about it now. Think about it now. When Bible class starts again, how beautiful it would be for us to come together in prayer as a community of believers. We are all believers, aren't we? Is that a yes? I don't see everybody saying yes. Okay. And it's a beautiful experience. It's learning from each other. Philip, we're supposed to be walking kids. Walking. Thank you. You're running. Okay. Anyway, learning to come together and build up our community is a good thing. There's so much we can learn from each other, okay, about God, about each other, and building each other up. Sometimes we may go through some things, we don't have anybody to talk to. Call your brother or sister, say, hey, I need prayer. I need your help in prayer. And maybe their faith in God, standing on what they've learned, using the gifts that God has given them of encouragement or joy or being able to listen can help build you up. Therefore, it just continues to build the community. Amen? Are we in agreement with that? So raise your right hand. Everybody ain't raising their right hand.
It's
come on now. Right, raise your right hand, please.
What
just
for?
Go with the community, ma'am. Please, my sister.
Say that again.
Just go with the community of raising your right hand. Repeat after me. Ready?
Yes.
I will do my best. To come to prayer service. When it starts again.
And
be consistent. Because it will build up my spiritual community. Okay, I took a snapshot of all y'all. Okay. That's all I have for you this evening. It's 10 minutes to 8. We're ready for the other class. The rest of the classes to come up. Anybody have any questions, any comments?
I've got a question.
Yes, sir.
You started to get 3 points.
Pardon?
Started to get 3 points.
Starting what?
Started to get 3 points.
Yes, sir.
3 points.
When
what were the 3 points?
Oh, what were the 3 points? Yes, worship in the wilderness. And that's significant for today, too. We all have wilderness experiences. What do we do in the wilderness? Do we just sit there, why God, why me, why am I going to do this? Or do we worship in the wilderness? You ever tried that? I know it works for me. Okay, the second one, sir, is readiness mentality. That means at any time God can change your situation, but you got to be ready in here and in your spirit. And financial planning. Just a little snippet on financial planning. If you're a faithful tither, God will give you the wisdom with your financial planning. You give him that tip, he'll orchestrate the other 90%. I'm a living witness on that one too. Amen?
Yeah.
All right. Any other questions? Concerns? I will see you all again on Friday. Miss Jackie will be doing class tomorrow. All right? Who'd like to do our closing prayer? Please? Yes, sir. Yes, do, please. No, I don't have it. You guys do.
Prayer. Lord, call us to worship in the wilderness.
Did I hear you? You can do the points real quick.
You got the 3 points.
I'm going to call it. Second? Somebody's going to second?
Kanye.
Second call it. Okay, call us up. Thank you.
We sure got
Thank Kanye. You. Thank you, Colin. All right, Colin.
I refuse all y'all to mind.
There's no running.
Well, we should have said Tanya Morton. We should have said Tanya. Oh, she came in late.
Lord Jesus.
That is the cutest dress.
Thank you.
No, I was asking you for a paper because I didn't have one.
I didn't have just one.
Oh, yeah. The class.
Don't be taking me.
I'm not.
Hebrew brothers. That's right.
Oh. The Hebrew brothers.